Hey yo, the Gaming Bronc here with another episode of City Skylines, the City of Job, and here we are, swimming in Muck Canyon. That's the name of our district that we assigned for our sewage and water treatment plant. Let's come back out of the water here. Isn't she a beauty? Now, we did, we did end up rearranging some of these things a little bit, but I think it ended up turning out okay. Holy cow, that is quite tall. Let's get up here a bit. There we go. Take a look down at it. We ended up putting a little garbage landfill over there and a couple incinerator plants to go with our beautiful sewage treatment facility here. Looking good. So, Muck Canyon it is. I think it looks all right, you know. I don't think it looks too bad. It's good for my first effort with the map editor tool, to be earnest, my first real effort. I don't count the solar power plant thing, because that was really a one-time deal over there, and it was just leveling things. But this road turned out a lot better than I could have hoped. You know, originally I had it going up this direction somewhere, but I decided to take it down around the edge of the canyon. It turned out really cool. And then, of course, we have a little intersection to go down to again, a little switchback here to come down into the landfill and the incinerator plants. And it looks pretty cool, I think. I think that's doing really well. Our power lines trailing along the canyon. It looks nice as far as waste facilities go, I think. And I found out that these guys, actually, since they clean the water out, they put water back into your system. So that gave us a double bonus there, because now our water availability went up as well as our sewage treatment. So that turned out being a really good option there. I'm glad we did that. And that makes a lot of sense, since we're treating the sewage here. We're not just dumping it out here. We can actually put the water back into our system. So hopefully nobody's drinking poo water, but you know, that's what those do, and that's pretty cool, I think. So that's looking nice. And then I ended up kind of, since we had this road that had to come through here anyway, I went ahead and built a small town named Crescent, right on the edge of the highway, and we put in our first railroad depot. It's a cargo railroad on a one-way loop here to try and manage it. And at first, the traffic was just freaking out of control, you know, with these railroads. Everyone from the city was coming down here to use this railroad, and I had traffic backed up. Ridiculous. So I went ahead and put another second railroad in. In a location that I had planned to put one. It doesn't fit exactly the way I want it to, so we are definitely going to end up reworking this, because this just doesn't work for me. I mean, if you look at this intersection, and that's Bush League. Like, that just can't possibly fly. So you got traffic crossing traffic to try and get in there. And since we have two stations like this, it's not been too bad, but like right now, you're watching it. It's just, that's just out of control. It just can't, it bothers me a little bit. So we do have our first two rail stations, both connected to our regional lines, and both cargo stations. I definitely plan on putting in a off region line, rail station for, pedestrians. Or not pedestrians, but for passengers. And I plan on putting a on-region line over here for passengers as well. Right here is where there's going to be an on-region line for them. I was thinking, I'm not sure. I know I'm going to put a train station in here. That's just too good a location to not put one. I'm just not sure what kind of train station right now. But, so yeah, so we built ourselves a little city over here. I think Crescent's got a population of 2,000 now, and we kind of grew our population up a little bit, which is nice. We have a lot more growing. We still have a lot of these icons. We don't have enough workers, so we have a lot more growing to do. We have lots of those icons, and that's problematic in a couple of ways. And for whatever reason, and I don't understand it, but the Flatiron Building is like right next to a police headquarters, and it's always got crime. It's like the most criminal building in the world. It's the only building in my city that has crime all the time. Every time I come over here, there's a crime happening at the Flatiron Building. I think that's all I did off camera. I got the trains going. You know, they're on big offshoots. This one goes on to come out here so that hopefully I don't get into train jams. Like, there should be plenty of space there, I think, for them. But you'll see, you know, the traffic coming in and out from these train stations is massive. This wraps and comes right here. Right now, like I said, I really don't like the way this works. Like, I got a feeling I'm going to end up tearing up this whole intersection here and reworking it at some point, but that's a task for me off camera because we definitely need to do that, but I just don't have the gumption to do it right now. So, because right now what I want to do is I want to start building on to this Hemlock Square over here. I really like Hemlock Square. I want to kind of grow Hemlock Square a bit, and I think I'm going to take Hemlock Square is going to be like this. I think we're actually going to go to work here on Hemlock Square, and I want Hemlock Square to eventually absorb all of this, and it will. It's just going to take time and sort of, there we go. Yeah, obviously, Hemlock Square is not going to jump the highway here, but whoop, draw that in. There we go. All right. There we go. Looks good. Okay, so we got our Hemlock Square outline done. Now it's time to go to work on it. So I'm thinking, that's all done. Let's get that back to collecting dead bodies. I was kind of thinking here, I'll take this four-lane road now. We have lights here anyway, and that intersection is doing pretty good. So I think I'm going to take this four-lane road and bring it out and turn it to kind of be the main avenue right here, is what I'm kind of thinking. So let's go ahead and start this process. Okay, I think we're just going to grab this turn tool right away because I'm going to bring it. I want to make a 90-degree turn on it if I can. Holy cow. Okay, get me to 90 degrees. There we go. I think that's it right there. And yes, I want to make a 90-degree turn like that. Perfect. And then let's see how that takes us here. That'll lead us to an interesting intersection, but I actually want to come right down the middle. So we're going to go something like this. Boom. And then we'll take this tool. I kind of like this redraw tool. Right like that. All right, that's kind of gives it a little swerve there, and that's nice. That's really nice. I like that. Okay. So there's our main, that'll be our main avenue. We could do a small intersection right here on that edge. To be honest, we should probably do some kind of intersection over here. We do have the capabilities over here to put in an intersection and kind of relieve some of this tension. Because you can see here, I got a number of passenger traffic coming in, turn right. I mean, and traffic is flowing, so I have no problem. This intersection actually worked. I have to say, this intersection actually worked a heck of a lot better than I actually anticipated it. Just because this sheer traffic from the industrial area, I thought this was just, there was no way. But as you can see, this is really handling itself. It's not a lot of traffic either. I don't want to confuse anybody. There ain't a lot of traffic on it either, but it looks busy. It looks busy, and, you know, it's getting the job done. So there. Yeah. But I think we could do a big intersection over here, because I think I'm going to do a lot of commercial down this avenue now. And then just off the commercial, I'm going to be doing some offices to kind of meet the needs that we got here. And then behind that, I'm going to fill in some high density residential. But let's grid this out a bit so we can see exactly what we got going on. We are going to do very gritty, a very grid-like section here, because we need to try and, well, I mean, we just want to kind of get a good city vibe from this. And as much as I love these organic sections, like, well, this looks really good too. I mean, I don't know. There's something about this nice grid that just looks like a town. Like, that looks like a legit town. And the same feeling I have for this high density grid. I mean, I've seen those types of blocks, and so I like them. I don't, is that fair? I don't know. But yeah, it just looks good, and I think we're gonna do some more of that. And we have a very unique looking grid here anyway, so why not? I think we're going to, and we'll definitely be filling this area out too, so fear not. But I'm wondering, let me grab the straight tool, wondering what happens to an intersection like this if we go straight off it. Not much. It looks nice. Okay, let's see. I want to go straight off that one and then create a block there. That looks good. I think we're gonna do that on all of those. We kind of create ourselves some blocks. Kind of a change in the grid, if you will, there, which looks good, I think. So there you go. We could do a little on there, but we don't want to. I don't want to have, we've got a ton of connections trying to work that out already, so that'll work. Let's see. I think that looks good. No! Thought I had you where I wanted you. Alright, let's see here. All right, it doesn't show a bridge when I click it, but it turns into a bridge. So, see, it's not showing a bridge right now. Oh, there it went. All right, good, that's what I want. Couple of little dead ends there. That'll work. And then if I go up two and over, that's my kind of usual grid pattern, is two and in. It just kind of variated it there for those. I think I'm gonna stick to that variation right there. Get that in there. Something like that. That looks pretty cool. That would leave some empty space there. Let's see here. If we go that way down. All right, that's pretty cool. We do something like that. That's unique. Oh, it's building a bridge. That's what it's doing. Yeah, what if I don't want to build a bridge? There. There. Oh, we have a little flooding. A little flooding. So the ground's a little low over here. Yeah, the road did not raise that up very high. That's for sure. Okay. Well, I don't want to tell you what. We might have something for this. Let me look and see. I think I have a building that will work really good down here. I just thought of it now. It's the marina. Where is the marina at? It'll be a cool building to kind of put down in this area, I think. Gosh, where did it go? It's Paul Brown. I know I have one. I don't remember where it is, though. Marina Resort, where are you? I want to say it's like in this area somewhere. You throw the White House in there. Red Tower. Colossal Order. Maybe it's in parks, I guess, because I'm striking out here. And it's not in landmarks. Okay, it's got to be in parks then. Let's see. It's called the Marina Resort. Did I lose it? Oh, that would be the perfect asset for this location. We could put the lighthouse there. That might be kind of cool. Could always build a beach down there too. Let's see what the lighthouse would be. The lighthouse could set right down here on the edge. Let's look at that. You know, for the time being, that looks, you know, I don't like that. We're going to come back to that area. I think I'm going to find the Marina Resort and put it there. It's an asset that I got to go download somewhere. I thought for sure that I had it, but apparently I do not. And I could sit here for a while looking for it and not find it. So I'm not going to put you through that torture, but we'll have something unique kind of in there. I think the Marina Resort will look really cool in there. So we'll either there or there. We'll put it in one of these squares. All right, so let's take a look at intersecting. I'd like to kind of keep. Okay, so there's two, and then we could intersect this road like this. I think that'll be okay, because then we can come down one, go over. Okay, yeah, something like that. I think that'll work. I think that'll work. Came just a smidge too far on that. Yeah, I don't want to wreck those 4x4 zones. Okay. I want to get rid of that. All right. Let's go ahead and zone this thing out and see what actually will pop up here. We need lots of office space, so let's... I'm going to drop some offices in. Put the offices on the river there, and then we're gonna go high density residential to kind of fill in that and this one. Okay, there we go. And then let's get our plumbing in. There we wiped out that industrial need right quick there. That worked pretty slick. All right, sweet, sweet. And then I think grab a couple of these high density commercial. Drop those in. There, and that should start springing up a bit. I think we got our good connections on this main avenue. We got one over to this main avenue. That should work really slick. I think we got two areas for a little something. Let's see if we can't drop in a little park here. This is kind of a wealthier side of town. Let's drop in an urban hockey rink. I think that'd be kind of cool. Well, let's put it somewhere where it's not going to wreck everything. That might be a good location, actually. Let's maybe over here. Can't build on water. Okay, yep. It's gonna be difficult, is what it's gonna be, because it's just the wrong size. It's one square too small. Okay. We're gonna go right there with you then. See how that, once you get some power, there you go. Yeah, that's nice. So we gotta put in a little urban hockey rink. Put a large playground in down here somewhere. I'm gonna put this large playground right here on this intersection. I know that's probably, I know I just blew up a bunch of people's houses. Not a problem for me. Alright, so we got our large playground in. Let's look at some schools. At some point here, I want to use these big... I think, you know, let's... I don't really want to build it on the lake, but let's look at using this these big schools. Do an elementary, big elementary school down here. Holy smokes. I haven't figured out exactly how I want that complex to look, though. That's going to be a big complex, because I have a whole slew of schools here, starting with ABC, or starting with the ABC Elementary, and then you got Annex A, Annex B, and then XYZ High, XYZ High, XYZ High, and then you got College of Engineering, University 101, and where's the third university structure? There it is, College of Science. So it's a whole big structure. You could really create a complete education compound that looks like a very modern university. So I suppose it actually, this Hemlock might not be a bad place to put that, because of its it's going to be one of my, it's already got 14,000 people in it. It might be my biggest. Hamsterdam's got 12,000. Yeah, burnt down building. Let's see what New Umber. New Umber is only at 8,000. I mean, Hemlock might already be my biggest city, because I don't think Cedar's got... Oh, Cedar's got 14,000. Hemlock's clearly going to end up being bigger than Cedar, though. Of that, there's no doubt. Just because of the sheer space Hemlock's going to take up. And so maybe this is a good location to do that. I'm sure thinking that it might be, but I think that'll be a project for another day. But yeah, what's the deal? Like, Flatiron Building has always got crime. Always. Look how quick all that came in. That's really nice. Yeah, we're definitely going to need to have some highway connections. Otherwise, I can see this. Yeah, it's getting flooded. They're trying to get goods down to that new commercial zone. I'm thinking. Where are you going? It's not the new one, but we're still struggling to get goods over here. Definitely. And it's because this is divided. I bet if I changed this to a six-lane road, I would have less problems. That median forces trucks to come this way. I wonder if I got rid of the median, if that would make a difference. I don't think that needs to be a four-lane road there. Nope, it sure didn't. That was a remnant of a different time when I was gonna. I was thinking of continuing that four lane all the way up to here, and then doing an intersection. Boy, maybe that's not a bad idea actually. Crap! If I'm gonna do that, I gotta empty this. Let's get that empty. We empty this. I think I'm gonna change this into a four lane all the way up to here. Create an intersection for it. That'll be an intersection right in the middle of my Hemlock Square here. And that should help maybe alleviate some of this, because then these goods could come via the highway, right? I think so. I really hope so. We're going to try it anyway. We'll see. Worst case scenario, another intersection here doesn't hurt us at all. So we're definitely going to be doing that. I think that's good. I'm going to fix this section here off camera. I'm going to do some work on assets and finding the assets that I need slash want to continue to grow my city. I hope you're enjoying the City of Job. I sure am. This is still one of my favorite looks at the city. I'll probably throw in some more public transit as well as far as bus routes. I'm starting to get to the point where Hemlock needs a bus route and doesn't currently have one at all yet. So, I'll maybe look at some schools and doing some layouts for some schools. As far as a big education center for Hemlock, I think it's about time that we start taking on some of these responsibilities as mayor. So that's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm going to do. We got some dead people laying around now because I got this guy trying to expel his deceased into the crematoriums. I hope you're enjoying it. If you are, please comment, like, subscribe as you feel called. I'd really appreciate it. And until next time, comrades, game on and happy Labor Day!